Welcome to the Blazor AI AssistView tutorial. In this video, I will show you how to get started with the Syncfusion Blazor AI AssistView component. With this component, you can easily send prompts, execute commands, and interact with AI through an intuitive toolbar. Plus, you can receive instant AI-generated responses or connect to powerful services like OpenAI and Azure Cognitive Services for real-time assistance. Before proceeding, ensure that you have the .NET 8 SDK and Visual Studio 2022 installed on your machine. After installing the necessary tools, launch Visual Studio 2022 and click Create a New Project from the dashboard. From the list of project templates, select the Blazor web application and provide the project name. I am using .NET 8 as the framework for this project and have selected the auto render mode for both server and WebAssembly apps under the interactive render mode section. Apart from this, there are four other modes. To learn more about interactive render modes, check out the video linked in the YouTube card above. I'll continue the project creation with the global interactivity location. When I click the Create button, the project creation will start. Now, the application is ready to use. Next, I'll show you how to add the Blazor AI AssistView component. First, I need to install the NuGet package in my application. So let me open the NuGet package manager, switch to the Browse tab, search for the Syncfusion Blazor Interactive Chat NuGet package, and install it. Also, I install the themes NuGet package to host the CSS and script files. After installation, let me navigate to the imports razor file and add the Syncfusion Blazor interactive chat namespace to use the component within the pages folder. Next, I open the client-side program CS file and add the Syncfusion Blazor namespace. Then I register the Syncfusion Blazor service to use the Blazor AI AssistView component. Also, ensure that the Syncfusion service is registered in the server-side program CS file. Next, I navigate to the AppRazor component, host the script, and refer to the CSS for the component. Now everything is configured. Open the HomeRazor component, remove the default code, and define the Syncfusion Blazor AI AssistView component inside a division tag with the specified height and width of the division element. This creates an interactive chat interface where users can ask questions and receive responses from the AI system. Let's run the application. You can see the interactive chat interface. Notice the text input box at the bottom. I can type in a question and receive a response from the AI system, demonstrating how the AI AssistView component works seamlessly within the Blazor app. Next, I will show you how to use templates in the Blazor AI AssistView component. The AI AssistView offers several template options to customize elements like the banner, prompt item, response item, suggestion, and footer. In this case, I'll use a banner template to display additional information such as a welcome note in the AI AssistView. To do this, inside the AI AssistView tag, I set the Assist Views tag, which holds multiple views. For this example, I will work with just one view. For that, I define this view using the Assist View tag, which serves as a unique, customizable view to display AI-powered content. Next, I add a banner template to customize the top section of the Assist View. This is a prominent section where I can add a title or introductory text. Inside the banner template, I create a division tag with the class banner content to structure and style the banner. I then add a heading tag and a span element with the classes eIcons and eAssistView icon, which pull in an AI-related icon from Syncfusion's library. Then I set the text AI assistance appear next to the icon, clearly indicating that this view offers AI-powered help. Below the heading, I add another division tag with the descriptive text Your Everyday AI Companion, explaining the purpose of the AI Assist view. Next, I apply basic CSS to center the text in the banner for a clean, visually appealing look. Now you can see the AI Assist view rendered with the customized banner template. Next, I'll show you how to configure suggestions and responses in the Blazor AI Assist view component. Let's begin by enhancing the component with prompt suggestions. These predefined prompts will provide helpful suggestions for common queries, improving interaction and guiding you more effectively. To achieve this, I'll add the prompt suggestions property. This property allows you to present a set of suggested questions or topics that you can select from, helping them engage with the AI component more efficiently. So let me add the code block. Here I'll define a list of string name task suggestions. In this list, I'll include predefined prompts such as, how do I prioritize my tasks? And how can I improve my time management skills? These suggestions will be displayed in the AI Assist view, making it easy for users to start interacting with the AI. Finally, I bind this list to the prompt suggestions property. Looking here, when the AI Assist view is rendered, you'll see the predefined suggestions. You can either choose one of the provided prompts or type your own questions to receive responses from the AI. Next, I'll show you how to configure responses in the Blazor AI Assist view component. To begin, I'll create a class named ChatResponseModel, which will hold both the user's prompt and the corresponding AI response. Next, I'll define a list of type ChatResponseModel called ResponseData. This list will contain predefined responses that the AI Assist view component can use to answer specific user prompts. I set the multiple chat response model. Each chat response model object pairs a question with a carefully crafted, predefined answer. This setup is particularly useful for handling common queries where immediate and accurate responses are needed. Now I'll add the prompt requested event. This event is triggered whenever a user submits a question or prompt in the Syncfusion AI Assist view component. To handle the prompt request, I create a private asynchronous method named handlePromptRequest, which takes an argument of type assistViewPromptRequestedEventArgs. This argument contains information about the user's prompt, and you can use it to set the response. Inside this method, I introduce a 3 seconds delay. The delay reflects the typical time it takes for the AI to handle and respond to your request. After the delay, I check whether the user's prompt exists in the predefined response data list. This list contains pairs of user prompts and predefined AI responses. Next, I search the response data list for the first entry where the user prompt matches the user's input. If there is a match, the corresponding predefined response will be used. If the user's prompt doesn't match any of the predefined options, I define a fallback response. This message will be used when there is no specific predefined response for the prompt. Finally, I set the response property of the args object to either the matching predefined response or the fallback message, depending on whether a match was found. After that, I'll bind this method to the prompt requested event. Let's run the example application. When I select a prompt suggestion, you'll notice the Stop Responding button appear. If you want to stop the response, you can click this button. Now you'll see the AI provides the predefined response. When I click another prompt, the AI provides a different response as expected. If I submit a new prompt, like "What is AI?" you'll notice the AI returns the fallback response. Now let me summarize. I showed you how to get started with the Syncfusion Blazor AI Assist view component. I also demonstrated how to use the banner template in the AI Assist view component, as well as how to configure prompt suggestions and responses. If you want to see the working code of this example, you can download it from the GitHub link in the description below. I've also provided a link to see if you qualify for a free community license to use all our Blazor components. If you find this video useful, don't forget to click the like button and subscribe to our channel to watch more videos like this. Thanks for watching.